everyone, no one has any idea what the vlog is. Our
vlog is just drunk us talking about the EU.
European Union, never heard of her.
Smile for the vlog.
Hi, hairstyle.
Wait, what's my mom then? 16-year-old.
February.
Gouffre.
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 What are we looking at?
The most beautiful monument that's ever been constructed in the entire European Union.
February.
I'm telling you, man, you just give me a couple beers and I get all political. Europeans, Union,
February.
Useless, US is the best, and let's not forget democratic deficit, am I right, everybody?
So Dan, what did you learn about Europe today?
I learned that they have really
February.
Good beer. The European Union is kind of like a cluster.
February.
They organize themselves well in theory, but like, and it's a top-down system, and elitist.
It was really cool to be in the rooms where world leaders come and meet and
February.
Talk about their problems.
February.
Welcome to the EU. Where nothing gets done.
February.
Charlotte, describe the European Union in three words.
28 member states.
How would you describe today's UKIP speaker?
I mean, he's what you'd expect. He was anti-immigrant, anti-climate change, anti-everything that we'd ever consider good.
This gives us a really good lesson in politics versus policy. And the fact that he got us so emotionally riled up is a testament to how British politicians can convince 52% of the population that an economically irresponsible idea is what is best for those people.
What do you think will happen with Brexit?
I think it's going to be a hard Brexit.
Okay, what do you think will happen? What do you think?
No comment right now.
Hard Brexit.
Hard Brexit.
I feel like Britain's going to have a lot of buyer's regret.
So Brussels really helped me understand Euroscepticism and understand kind of the roots of it and how people can become disillusioned with the European Union. Our program definitely tends to provide a very biased perspective. So it was interesting to hear from people like Stuart Agnew, who, while slightly crazy, generally seemed like at heart a nice person, even though a lot of his beliefs were crazy. And to understand how someone like that can become so anti-European Union.
I'm here with Herr Alder. What are your thoughts to seeing the other perspective of the Crimean conflict when visiting the Russian embassy?
History in Russia is very different than history in the US, just how it's taught, how it's kind of expressed, how you learn about it. And I think that the biggest difference was that Russia does not think they're at fault at all for the deteriorating of the relationship between Russia and the European Union. They blame it all on the West and the EU, and they also blame NATO for most of it too. There's just a lot of Russia not blaming themselves for something that they are just legitimately at fault for.
Seeing the European Central Bank firsthand was really quite impressive. It's kind of crazy to think about trying to tie together multiple economies with all sorts of different industries and businesses into a single monetary plan with a single interest rate, a single reserve and all that sort of stuff. The guy we talked to was really, really optimistic about the bank's ability going forward to maintain a strong financial system. But he did tend to skirt past some of the major questions we had about whether or not it's capable of providing strong economic backbones for each country individually.
I thought it was really interesting to hear the Turkish diplomat at the Turkish mission in Brussels, because he was talking about how pro-EU Turkey is, when it's just, there's a lot of contradictions between Turkish values that don't line up with the democratic values of the EU. And his argument's really interesting when he was saying that Turkey would provide a lot for the EU, including geopolitical advantages into the Middle East. It was interesting when he said that if the EU acquires a Muslim state, that it would actually decrease Islamophobia and xenophobia in the EU, which I have a hard time believing, especially after hearing the UKIP members' position.
All right, so you know how Euroscepticism is kind of a problem?
Yeah.
I understand why.
So sing the sea. So. No.